So, Trophy Hunters, King Super One has just signed in, and welcome to the August edition of the Flash Sale. Well, you saw the update earlier. Now, let's get this started. For this game, I'm guaranteed you can just go to GameStop, play the game, and then sell it within a week. Easy. Other than the Assassin's Creed Chronicles that are on sale, I mean, if you want to get this Battlefield Hardline Ultimate Edition for $9, I mean, have fun with the online trophies. You see that Dead Rising 2? That's $6. If you want to drive around and kill fucking 70,000 zombies, I mean, go ahead, man. $6 definitely worth the money. Anytime you ever see any DLCs on sale, you better get it. Unless it's the game you actually have, get it, please. Just get it. Look at this, Dragon Age for $10. Why not? Go get it. Three games for a price of $10 is definitely always worth it. You get Need for Speed, Plants vs. Zombies Gone with for $2, and fucking Unravel. So I really suggest you actually get this if you can. Earth Dawn looks like a 3 out of 10 under 35 hours, so I'm actually considering getting this. I mean, I don't have Grow Up, but you know what? Let's get it. If anyone's interested in King's Quest, I mean, $10 is not that bad. You might as well go get it. So basically, this is MotoGP 16, and this is definitely worth the money for me, so I'm definitely getting this. What the fuck is this game? This game actually has a fucking platinum. Oh my god. I'm gonna hold out until someone actually fucking plays this to see how it is, but I'll get it when it's like the same price next time. 1 out of 10, 3 hours for $2. Yeah, definitely worth getting. 5 out of 10, under 10 hours. Okay, you know what, I'll get it. Now, if this was the PS3 Battleship, this would probably be worth the money, but I don't know about the board game, but it's up to you if you want to get it or not. I don't want to play it. I don't want to play it. I don't want to play it. I don't want to play this game. I really, really don't want to play this game. I'm only going to get this game when it's cheaper. So if there was a battle between this game and Steep, yeah, I'm going for Steep, so fuck this game. I'm pretty sure I just talked about this already, but yeah. Literally, I can self-boost this on the PS3, but the game is so much ass, so fuck that. Oh, what do you know? Another GameStop game. Oh my godheads? It even has a platinum? Oh my godhead. I'll wait till it's cheaper. I mean, for $3, it isn't that bad, but I'm not gonna get that, so it's your choice if you want to get it or not. Yeah, this is by Bastion and Transistor. I'm definitely buying this. Do you want to take that risk, or take that risk? Why does this game look like Ride to Hell 2? I'm only getting it when it's cheaper. Now, which one of these three you think is worth the money? You decide. Now, if there was a battle between these three games, I think Zombie would probably be the good choice. I think it's time for me to purchase this game, so I might as well get it now. Oh, look, an easy platinum on sale. I don't know how much it is, but get it. What is this, the spiritual successor of Farming Simulator? And it has a platinum? Oh yeah, definitely worth getting. I think out of these three games, Mirror's Edge is probably the best game to get, so I suggest you get that. As for me, nah. Oh, what do you know? Plants vs. Zombies 1 and 2 was on sale. What about Star Wars Battlefront? Isn't it even worth it? We'll never know. Soon, Prototype. Real, real soon. In all honesty, this game is not even stackable, so why the fuck would they not make this a cross-buy game? Like, I don't fucking understand. I'm gonna be stuck on the PS3 for a while. In which, by the way, it's better to get this version of the PS4 instead of the PS3, because if you actually buy the PS3, it's a trap! Yeah, I think it's time for me to buy Red Faction 2, so yeah, I'm getting that too. So these are the games I'm getting right here. So, onward to the PS3 section. Okay, this is going to be tough, so let's get started. Between these three games, DuckTales Remastered is worth. Bioshock, you can just get the Bioshock Ultimate Rapture Edition. Borderlands 2, get the Borderlands 2 Game of the Year Edition. Grid Autosport, I don't even know if you even want to try to 100% that. Possibly the only game I'll get from out of these three games, so I'll definitely get that. Criminal Girls 2, yeah, I'm definitely purchasing. I mean, if you feel like taking that biggest risk of your whole entire life, you go ahead and get this game since it's $3. Look, it's everyone's favorite game that nobody wants to play. I think it's worth the time to actually get it now. Oh, look, another game nobody wants to play because they're too scared to do the fucking Apocalypse Flame. I think it's worth getting now. Oh, look at this, Dogfight 1942, Dogfight 1942 Bundle. Both $2. The fuck is this bullshit? You know, I always see Lost Planet 3 on sale every single time, and it's always cheap. I'm not sure if it's even, like, worth it. I'm so, like, sometimes I just really want to fucking get the game just for the hell of it, but I don't even know if I even want to play Lost Planet 3. After playing Lost Planet 2 on Xbox, I mean, I don't know, man. Tell me what y'all think about Lost Planet 3, if it's even worth getting or not. You know what? I'm going to consider getting this game, because I don't know what it is, but it's whatever. Oh, look at that. The Hard Platinum and the Easy Platinum for $10. So, I think I suggest you get it now. Since it doesn't have a Platinum, only feels cheaper, yes. So, these two games are only ones I want to get in the PS3 section. And that's basically it. With 8 games purchased on the flash sale, I have spent a total of $40.92. You can also go to kingsuper1.com with all the flash sale purchases I bought, starting with this video throughout. So, stay tuned for some Bayonetta action as you are listening to the best trophy hunter ever.